So my narrative is not really about just one book. It's about has played a role in our lives, in our quest for finding our real home over the last 30 years. The book is called Dust in the Mountains by Ruskin Bond, but we'll talk about it in a bit. So as my name suggests, I'm back and grew up in Calcutta, not really. Grew up in a joint family. Married my neighbor's sweetheart. I was lucky. She perhaps was judgmental, but we've been together for the last 30 years. But since then, I've been out of Calcutta chasing a career in MNCs all over the country and some parts of Asia, which is where I met Annie. And very recently in an Indian startup, as she just mentioned in Lenskart, I stay in this amazing place called Gurgaon, or Kurukshetra, as you might like it, or Gurgaon. I have sold soaps, tea, cheese, margarine, jeans, mosquito repellents, and now I win. So I must credit myself to have a range of diverse things to have peddled all my life. I am blessed, thankfully, with an ear for music and a wife who's a recorded artist, so that helps my sanity. I love music, and whilst I listen to a range of music, my energy comes from the music of R.D. Burman and the poetry of Gulzar. I play the guitar a bit, so I can jam fearlessly with my friends. I like traveling, as Gulzar Saab says, "Raah pe rehte hain, khabo pe pasar karte hain, khush raho ahle watan, hum to safar karte hain." Ever since childhood, I've been in love with the life in the mountains. Parents and sister were often in Darjeeling, Kalimpong, Gangtok, and even my honeymoon was in Darjeeling, sponsored by my uncle, of course. No pride for guessing that I am a quintessential Bong, right? So Bongs without Darjeeling don't add up. Fortunately, Tina, my partner for more than 30 years, also loved the mountain. As we walked through the streets of Calcutta building our relationship, we promised each other a simple life. All we wanted in life was a small house in the mountains, our kids attending a small village school, music in the evening, she is a classical musician, long walks on a Sunday, and of course, momos and mountain food. However, my chance admission to a business school changed all this. Ambition, aspiration, marriage, kids, their careers, their future took over. And mountains kept getting more and more distant as we trudged along through our monthly and quarterly commitments made to many corporations and our ever-trusting consumer banks who were always ready to offer loans for things we thought we needed. An extra bedroom here, a condo with a swimming pool, a personal lift lobby, and oh yes, these modern-day chariots with their war crests. So the list became endless. As we were building a life together across 6 cities and 18 apartments, we were also building a bookend of promises to sometime live in the mountains. We kept telling each other in Bengali, "Mone ache to," that someday we will get to the mountains. And we kept promising each other, yes, that we should not forget our promises. We kept walking along with fleeting reminders of the early life promises on a Sunday evening. Sunday is usually the time when you really want to get out of Monday, and therefore you seek a home, a life that you've never got, right? It happens to all of us. This was a Sunday in Bombay, sometimes in Bangalore, sometimes in Jakarta, Singapore, and now increasingly in this part of the country, which is Gurgaon. After some time, we actually stopped going through this charade. No, we gave up. Over many, many years, the bookend of promises started gathering dust, till one day, a favorite uncle of ours introduced us to Ruskin Bond, or Rusty as he's better known as. And so started our life in the mountains. Rusty showed us the Lal Tibba from the room on the roof. We walked the paths with the rain in the mountains. We met Dayaram while time stopped at Shamli, and we also waited along with the woman in Platform 8 and with Rusty as he waited to board a train back home. And whilst our bookend blossomed, fate brought us the battlefields of Kurukshetra, Gurgaon, which we discovered was a 7-hour drive to Lander, the home of Ruskin Bond. And finally, on the 19th of April 2014, we made our first trip to Lander. Lander is about 15 kilometers, for those who are not familiar, up from Missouri in Uttarakhand. It is a sleepy town inhabited by those who have kept moving up from the plains, right? The escape took them from Delhi to Dehra, from Dehra to Missouri, and from Missouri to Lander. And really, the escape was from tourist encroachments. And Lander, we found, was just as we imagined our life to be. small town, long mountain walks in the mist, hot steaming hill maggi at Char Dukan, coffee at the Lander Bakehouse, and a walk down to Lal Tibba. And Lal Tibba is what brought us closer home, the house of Ruskin Bond. And on the 20th of April 2014, and we remember this to the day, that's our anniversary, and it's the 25th anniversary, Trina and I were blessed with the best anniversary gift ever, a visit to Rusty's home, and a personally guided tour around his house. His house is about 12 steep steps up from the road and comprises of a living room, as you would guess it, but a Spartan one, full of books, a bedroom where his adopted family stays, and the room on the roof where Rusty lives and writes. The magic happened in that room when he opened the windows. Actually, the windows were open. He showed us the Lal Tibba, he showed us the mountains, he showed us the birds, and showed us all that inspired him to write the way he does. The room on the roof overlooks Lal Tibba and has quite a view of the mountains. It has a single cot, can't really call it a bed, and a table with handwritten manuscripts, each with a promise to lost souls like us to find a real home in the mountains. This is the room where a simple man with a simple pen provides a sanctuary to many souls lost in the maze of PowerPoint presentation. We call it death by PowerPoint, right? Excel sheets, analysis paralysis, algorithms, AI, and the quest of making balance sheets and profits and loss statements of faceless companies stronger and stronger and stronger. Now, there is a nasha to that as well. So this is not to really say that, look, my life of 30 years has been wasted. There's a lot to be done there as well. It keeps your intellect strong. It ensures that you never, ever will suffer from amnesia or Alzheimer's. It keeps your brain cells ticking. But that is only one part of the life. And what Rusty's helped us do is ensure that we treat our work only as one part of our life and not our life itself. Rusty gifted us Dust on the Mountains on our anniversary. This is the book, his handwritten note to Trina and Trina and Shumon. Great meeting you and good wishes for your success and happiness. 20th April 2014. So that really has held us together, quite honestly. I haven't shared a single story from the book with a purpose. These are stories not stories to be told, and neither are they stories to be read. They're stories to be lived. And you don't need to reach out to Amazon to buy Rusty. He will find you like he found us. That, in short, is really how a book has helped me and me keep my sanity alive and kept the dream of a young teenage couple alive in quest of their little home in the mountains forever. I'll sing the song that I sang to my wife in Lander, right, on our 25th anniversary in the evening. I'd carried my guitar in the evening post our visit to Rusty's place, because we had found our home finally. And one day we've promised each other we will go and live there. La 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 la. मगर लगते लगते हैं ये धरती ये नदियाँ ये नहर और थैंक यू वेरी मच.